I'm good.
You may enter.
Thank you, Chairman Hoshino. Captain Takabe said it would be okay for us to talk.
I heard. And I believe I already know why you've come. You've done us a great service. I would not still be leader of this clan if it weren't for you.
Does that mean the Seiryu clan's gonna pull through?
I can't say for sure yet. About 20 to 30% of our men defected to the Omi. The ones who stayed are grumbling behind my back. And it's hard to blame them. They just found out the Jincho standoff was all a sham.
Zhao told me he's giving up his position as the leader of the Liumeng. Songhui is going to lead them.
Yes, I know.
You just know everything, huh?
Not everything. But I'll tell you what I do know. Eventually, the Seiryu clan will succumb to the Omi Alliance.
What?
For people who had nowhere to live outside the Gray Zones, the Great Wall of Muscle was their only protection. Now it's crumbling. That's a matter of life or death for them. Already rumors are flying into Jincho's political circles. Rumors that Ogikubo's lost his touch. I'm sure Aoki got those whispers going. He never lets a good crisis go to waste.
Oh, really?
Aoki knows it would destroy the party if it ever revealed their chair, Ogikubo, forged money for years. Now, Aoki can easily blackmail Ogikubo and force him to step down.
I don't get it. Why does he want to take Ogikubo's place so bad?
The party chair manages elections, so in that role, Aoki could nominate anyone he wants. He'll control the ruling party. Therefore, he'll control the nation.
The whole country will be under his thumb?
Yes. Especially if I'm right about his next move. I think he's gonna try to dissolve Parliament.
Dissolve Parliament? At a time like this, that's insane!
Prime Minister, I understand how you must feel, being unable to rely on Ogikubo-sensei. But honestly, I have the power to support you better than he ever could. If an election were held today, I could guarantee you 2/3 of the seats, minimum.
Do you have a solid plan for doing that?
Yes. I'll send Bleach Japan to the districts where the Citizens' Liberal Party is weakest. Bleach Japan can influence votes anywhere. They're incredibly popular. Plus, they have my endorsement. A victory for the party would, of course, move your personal political goals forward.
Oh.
Tell me, do you think you have the power to maintain the party's stability right now? We don't want it breaking up for lack of support from Ogikubo-sensei.
You can talk that way to the house, but not to me.
Appoint me to party chair and hold an election. If you don't, I'll be forced to make public the nature of Ogikubo-sensei's crimes. That would mean the end of not only your administration, but the party itself.
But there's no precedent for someone serving as both governor and party chair. Besides, you're much too young.
If age is what you want, start digging for some old fossil who can stop me. That is, if you think you can find one. Anyone in particular come to mind?
Aoki's scheme to destroy the Great Wall worked. Now he's got Mabuchi and the Omi at his command. So much power, vested in just one man. Had to be Masato Arakawa. Kasuga. I know you never intended to be at the center of all this. It was pure coincidence that you were there when the soap landowner died. Wouldn't you agree?
Yep. Lucky me.
But one thing I don't believe is a coincidence is that you ended up in Ichinjo.
Huh? What do you mean?
Do you still have that fake bill?
Yeah, didn't you say you knew how it ended up on me?
Yes. Only one person in the world could have put that bill in your pocket.
Who? Who is it?
Masumi Arakawa himself.
Arakawa-san? No, he's the one who shot me.
Yes, I'm aware he shot you. But did you ever consider that maybe he did that so you would end up here?
What?
That fake bill was his letter of introduction between you and me. It was to let me know that you were one of Masumi Arakawa's men.
Kind of a weird way to introduce us, don't you think?
I think what it means is Arakawa's goals do not align with those of Ryo Aoki.
Well, then, what are Arakawa's goals?
I really can't say, but I do know that he means business. He wouldn't have used that bill if he didn't.
Chairman. How exactly do you know Arakawa-san?
Huh. Well, that's a long story. And there's a much better place than here to tell it. Heian Tower.
Heian Tower.
Yes. That's where my fate intertwined with Arakawa's. He sure seems to be partial to Peking duck.
Yeah.
Let's have it for lunch tomorrow. My treat. I'll make the reservation. Hey. Listen.
Okay.
Huh.
Yo.
Hey.
This could get rough.
What is your bakani suruna?
Scared?
See now.
Bring it on.
You're done now.
Ass-kicking time.
This'll be good.
spy. All right, let's do it.
You're in it now.
Take your best shot. I got this.
I'll show you a fight.
Take this.
A gift for you.
Weak.
Now we're talking.
You're in for it now.
Let's go!
Well...
Yeah.
Prepare to suffer.
Let's get it done! Feel it good. It's go time.
Oh. Eyes on me.
Watch. I got this. Want to fight? With finesse.
それでは出発いたします。
Chief.
Hmm?
My friend's got some questions about the day I was dumped in this town.
Yeah. I want to know why you didn't just abandon Ichiban, or dump him at a hospital. If you don't mind telling us, I'm sure we'd all appreciate it.
I see. Fine. And I'll tell you, it's as good a time as any.
What?
There's an old tradition in this homeless camp. A responsibility passed down through the chiefs for many years.
What responsibility?
On occasion, when we're asked, we dispose of bodies.
What? Bodies?
Yeah. There's a Yakuza family from Kamurocho who pays us to do it. They're called Arakawa.
Arakawa? Seriously? They... was this going on while they were still Tojo?
I don't know every detail, but yes. The arrangement existed at that time. It existed before I started living here. We've dealt with all kinds of bodies, whether they've been shot, stabbed, beaten. No matter how nasty, we dug holes and buried them under garbage. Who knows how many are there now? Back during the bubble, we got one every month, or so I was told. Since I became chief, there's only been three.
Damn. Arakawa the assassin.
But there's one more secret rule. It applies to anyone the Arakawa bring here alive.
Secret within the secret. Great.
What happens if they bring someone alive?
We're supposed to give the person medical aid, then let them go free, while pretending they're dead.
What's up with that?
In the criminal underworld, there's always people wanting to fake their own death. Gamblers, guys on the run, anyone who's afraid someone will hurt them. They send people like that here, and we honor the secret agreement. I think it might actually be a service the Arakawa family provides, but obviously they don't advertise it. So it ended up being a very rare event.
Is that agreement why you saved me? This live body rule?
You got it.
What sort of guy dropped me off here?
I mean, probably just someone from the family. I had no reason to check or anything. The guy lugged you out of the trunk of a car. You were covered in blood. He paid me and left. Didn't say a single thing the whole time.
I'm sorry, Ichi. You have to die. I'm counting on you, Ichi.
I think he said something. I think it was, I'm counting on you, Ichi.
What would that even mean?
No clue. But the more I think about it, the more I'm sure he said that.
Look, Ichiban.
What?
I don't want to dash your hopes or anything. When you were dumped here, you were on death's doorstep. You're only alive because everything I did went exactly the way we needed it to. But it could have easily gone a different way. I know you want to trust Arakawa, but...
I think Arakawa-san had to shoot me. All the other Yakuza at that meeting were watching him.
Huh?
Never mind. You don't get it. Forget I said anything.